Hello guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today we are talking about the most favorite object in this world. Money. You probably clicked the video because you disagree with my thumbnail, or you are just waiting for what I have to say about this subject. Saving money makes you poor. I repeat, saving money makes you poor. Let's start with the definition of saving. Saving is storing or putting away something. You get that right? Get that. So in our case, that's saving money. Let's head on to why we save money then. To meet unexpected events. What do I mean by that? Like the coronavirus, or popularly known as the COVID-19. The whole world was hit by this unseen threat unexpectedly. So in this case, those who have saved money will obviously ease some of their burden. I think everyone gets that. Two, to get that new stuff you've been chasing after. Maybe it's a new iPhone, it's a new Galaxy phone, that's Samsung, or it's a new Huawei phone. Yeah, that's why people will save money. You all know we can't just get up one day and decide to buy a new car unless you are rich. Yeah, obviously. Most of us save to accomplish those dreams. Dreams being that new car, that new phone, new console. Yeah, by the way, a new PS5 is coming out, or a new PlayStation is coming out, or a new motorcycle. Yeah, those guys. As you can see, the advantages to saving money. So then, why do I say saving money makes you poor? Let's look at the view of most people. That is, if you want to be rich, that's what most people say, or some people have heard say. If you want to be rich, you need to store or save most of your money, which is completely far from it. Far, 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 very far. Because prices of stamps keep increasing over the years because of inflation. But your saved money, or your stored up money, does not increase in value. This stays the same while the world keeps moving forward. That is, your stored up money loses value over the years. Example is, prices in 1952 were way lower if you compare to 2020 prices. So imagine someone saving money in 1952, thinking that saved money can buy stuffs in 2020. In 2020, you'll be poor because his saved up money won't be enough to buy things in our current era. Thank you guys for watching this video. If you like the video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you have any suggestions or any disagreement, you can comment it in the comment section below. Thank you very much, and see you in the next video. Bye.